Good morning, children. In your previous class, we studied about the clinical thermometer and the laboratory thermometer. See, children, clinical thermometer, it is used to measure the temperature of the human beings. And the laboratory thermometer, it is used to measure the temperature of the objects. Now, today, children, we will discuss some activities and also we will study about the how the heat is transferred. Means we will study about the transfer of heat. Now there is one activity here, children. You have to take some hot water in a beaker or a mug. Next, you have to dip the thermometer in the water. Now, the thermometer, it is having the mercury inside, children. You have to wait till the mercury thread becomes steady. Means it stops and then you note the temperature. See, first you have to take some hot water in a beaker or a mug. Then you have to dip the thermometer in the water. Now you have to wait till the mercury thread stops and then you have to note the temperature of the water. Now you have to take out the thermometer from the water. You observe carefully what happens. Now, do you notice that, children? As soon as you take the thermometer out of the water, the level of mercury begins to fall. See, children, as you take the thermometer out from the water, you observe that here the level of mercury begins to fall. This means that the temperature must be read while the thermometer is in water. Means, when the thermometer is in water, it gives you the correct reading. Now, you may recall that while taking your own temperature, you have to take the thermometer out of your mouth to note the reading. You already learned this, children. While taking your own temperature, means your body temperature, that time you have to take the thermometer out of your mouth to note the reading. Now, see, children. Can you then use the laboratory thermometer to measure your body temperature? See, children, as you used the clinical thermometer, you can't use the laboratory thermometer to measure your body temperature. Now, why does the mercury not fall or rise in a clinical thermometer when taken out of the mouth? See, children, you may have noticed this. Whenever you measure your body temperature, you'll keep the clinical thermometer in your mouth and you will measure it. But here you have to notice that the mercury will not fall or rise in a clinical thermometer. Why? Because here there is a kink near the bulb. See, children, this is the kink. It is called as the kink. It prevents mercury from falling on its own. See? In clinical thermometer, there is a small bend here, children, at the bottom of the tube. It contains the mercury and the kink. It prevents the mercury level from falling down on its own. And due to this, the temperature does not decrease immediately after removing the thermometer from the mouth. This kink, it helps, children. It prevents from falling off the temperature when the thermometer is taken out of your mouth. Now we will study about the transfer of heat. See, children, you might have observed that a frying pan, it becomes hot when kept on a flame. See, you may have observed that when a frying pan, it is kept on a flame, it becomes hot. This is because the heat passes from the flame to the utensil. See, now the heat passes from the flame to the utensil. Now, when the pan is removed from the fire, it slowly cools down. See, children, when the pan is removed from the fire, it slowly cools down. Now, why does it cool down? Means here, because the heat is transferred from the pan to the surroundings. See, children, first, when you kept the fan on a flame, it becomes hot because here the heat passes from the flame to the utensil. Now, when you removed the pan from the fire, it cools down because here the heat is transferred from the pan to the surroundings. Now, you can understand that in both the cases, the heat flows from hotter object to the colder object. See, children, in both the case, in first case also, first the frying pan was cold, the heat transferred from the flame to the frying pan. In second case, the heat transferred from the frying pan to the surroundings. In both the cases, the heat transferred from the hotter object to the colder object. In all the cases, the heat flows from the hotter object to the colder object. Now, how does this heat flow? Now, let us find out this, children. Here, one activity has been given here. You have to take a rod or a flat strip of a metal. See, children, you have to take a rod or a flat strip of a metal, say of a aluminium or it may be of a iron. Now, you have to fix a few small wax pieces on the rod here. You have to fix a small pieces of a wax on the rod. Now, these pieces, they should be at nearly equal distances. See, you observe here, children, they are kept at the equal distances on the rod here. Now, you clamp the rod to a stand. See, children, you have to clamp this rod to a stand. Now, if you do not find a stand, you can put one end of the rod in between two bricks. See, children, if you are not having the stand, you put one end of the rod in between two bricks. You observe the figure here, children. Two bricks have been kept and the rod is kept in between the two bricks here. Now, you have to heat the other end of the rod here, children. See, here the rod has been heated here. The candle has been shown here, children. The flame of the candle, it is heating the rod here. Now, what happens to the wax pieces? You observe, children. Now, do these pieces begin to fall? Which piece falls the first? See, children, obviously the piece which will be heated more, it will fall first. Means here the first piece of wax will be heated more, therefore it falls first here. Now, children, do you think that the heat is transferred from the end nearest to the flame to the other end? Understood, children? The heat is transferred from the end nearest to the flame to the other end. Means the heat is transferred to the piece which is near to that flame. Now, the process by which heat is transferred from hotter end to the colder end of an object, it is known as the conduction. See, children, you remember this. Conduction means it is the process by which heat is transferred from the hotter end to the colder end of an object. It is known as the conduction. In solids, generally, the heat is transferred by the process of a conduction. In solid object, children, generally, the heat is transferred from the process of a conduction. And it flows always from a hotter end to the colder end of an object. Now, do all the substances conduct the heat easily? You must have observed here, children, that the metallic pan for cooking has a plastic or a wooden handle. You may have noticed this, children. The metallic pan for cooking, it has a plastic or a wooden handle. Now, can you lift a hot pan by holding it from the handle without getting hurt? Yes, children, because here the metallic pan for cooking, it has a plastic or a wooden handle because it helps to hold even if the metallic pan is hot without getting hurt. Now here, another activity has been given here, children. Now you have to heat water in a small pan or a beaker. You have to heat the water in a small pan or a beaker. Now we have to collect some articles such as a steel spoon, plastic scale, pencil and a divider. See children, it has been shown in the figure here. Here heat water in a small pan or a beaker. You have to collect some articles like a steel spoon, plastic scale, pencil and divider. Now you have to dip one end of each of these articles in a hot water. Now we have to dip one end of each of these articles in hot water. Now you have to wait for a few minutes. Now touch the other end. Now enter your observation here. You can observe that one article has been shown here, steel spoon. It is a metal. And does the other end get hot? See children, it is heated. The steel spoon, the other end of the steel spoon gets heated like this. You try this activity children and you have to write your observations here. Now you have to heat all these objects, means you have to heat the, first you have to heat a water in a small pan or a beaker, then you have to collect some articles like steel spoon, plastic scale, pencil and divider. Now you have to dip each object in the hot water and you have to write your observation here. Now children, from this we can understand that here some materials will conduct the electricity and some will not. Means here the materials which allow the heat to pass through them easily, they are called as the conductors. Means usually the metals, they allow the heat to pass through them. Here the materials which allow the heat to pass through them easily, they are called as the conductors of heat. Examples are aluminium, iron, copper. These are all metals children. These are examples for the conductors. Means they easily allow the heat to pass through them. They are called as the conductors. And the materials which do not allow the heat to pass through them easily, they are called as the poor conductors of heat, such as a plastic and wood. The poor conductors, they are called as the insulators. Remember children, here you can observe from the activity. The metal spoon, it is a conductor, and the wood pencil and also the plastic scale, they are both the insulators, means they will not allow the heat to pass through them. For those we call as the insulators. Means conductor means they allow the heat to pass through them. They are called as the conductors. Examples are aluminium, iron and copper. Insulator means the materials which do not allow the heat to pass through them, they are called as the poor conductors. And also they are called as the insulators. Examples are plastic and wood. These are the insulators children. Understood children? Till now we discussed about some activities and also we understood about the transfer of heat and also the conductors and insulators. You read this all children. Next we will continue in our next class. Thank you.